हेलो माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ फोर्थ सेमेस्टर इलेक्ट्रिकल एंड इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स इंजीनियरिंग। आई एम हियर ललित कुमार पी भैया, एसोसिएट प्रोफेसर इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स एंड टेलीकम्युनिकेशन डिपार्टमेंट, भारती कॉलेज ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग एंड टेक्नोलॉजी दुर्ग। वंस अगेन today we will go through the subject analog electronics with especially a numerical on voltage shunt feedback amplifier. In last videos of the feedback amplifier we have seen numericals on voltage series, current series, etc. Today we will discuss and see How to identify the topology of the feedback, given feedback circuit, and how to solve the feedback parameters like closed loop gain, closed loop current gain, closed loop voltage gain, closed loop transconductance, closed loop trans resistance, input impedance, output impedance, etc. So let us see with this video a particular numerical on voltage shunt feedback amplifier. Before going to this particular circuit and amplifier, I would like to tell you in voltage shunt amplifier, the sampling is the voltage, while input mixing is the shunt, that is parallel. That's why it is called as a voltage shunt feedback. Input side is a shunt mixing and at the output side is a voltage sampling. So while feedback circuit takes the sample of the voltage and provides the current, so that feedback current will be in parallel with the input current source. Hence it is called as a shunt mixing, parallel mixing. So we have already seen the topology diagram and its analysis. Now we will go through the particular numerical. You can see this diagram here. This particular diagram is of voltage shunt feedback amplifier. And this circuit you can see here. The values are given. RC is equal to 2.2K. This R dash is equal to 50K, which is a feedback resistance. RS is equal to 10K, that is a source resistance. This VS is the source voltage. And the parameters of the transistors are HIE is equal to 1.1K and HFE is equal to 50. HFE is the forward current gain of a transistor, and here is a common emitter transistor. If you see properly, if you look this circuit, you can find this is the common emitter amplifier with collector to base bias. This is the collector and this is the base. So here the resistance is connected between collector and base. So this is called as common emitter with collector to base biasing. And hence, this circuit particularly treated as a voltage shunt feedback circuit. Output is the voltage across this RC. And this output voltage will provide the feedback current to this R dash. And now this feedback current will be in parallel with this current. We will convert this source, voltage source, into this resistance, into current source. So this current will be in parallel with this feedback current. Hence, we will find here the shunt mixing. And here is the feedback sampling voltage, output voltage. Therefore, it is voltage shunt mixing, voltage shunt feedback circuit. Now, what we will do in first step, this is the first step to identify the topology. While identifying the topology, we will keep this input open and find the output. And we will sort the output, we will find the input. So that we will get which type of sampling and which type of mixing. So we have already seen this one. In second step, we will find the input equivalent circuit and output equivalent circuit. So to find the input circuit here, this side, this output must be shorted. When we short this output, this R dash will be in parallel with the current source. We have to convert this Vs into Rs into Norton equivalent. And this Rs will be in then parallel to R dash. So we will get the parallel combination here as a current, so along with the current source when input is shorted. So we will get the input equivalent circuit. Now, to get the output equivalent circuit, keep it open. Remove this Vs here and keep it open. So what will happen? This R dash will be in picture at the output also. RC in series with the R dash. So we will get here the R dash. Let us look the circuit, equivalent circuit. This circuit you can find here. This is the Norton equivalent current source. This resistance Rs and this is R dash and this is R dash at the output side. So this circuit is the input and output circuit and whole circuit is the equivalent circuit. We have find the input circuit, we have got the output circuit by particular this identification or calculation of the input and output circuit. Once you get this input and output circuit, you have to mark this Rs and R dash parallel combination is referred as R. And the Ri is the input impedance looking from input side, included this R also, Rs parallel to R dash. And here, the HIE of the transistor, that is input impedance of the transistor is the HIE. This is shown here. This is feedback current IF. And this is R dash, which is connected between collector and base at the output equivalent side. We have got R dash. This I0 is particularly equal to IC1. Yeah, IC you can say. This is IB. And this is IF. And this is the output voltage shown here. So this circuit is the equivalent circuit. Now here, this IF is equal to VI minus V0 divided by R dash. In last previous circuit, R dash was connected between this and this. So IF is the flowing through this R dash. Therefore, it is Vs minus this V0 upon R dash is the IF. And this IF is approximately equal to minus V0 upon R dash because V0 is very, very greater than beta times VI. Therefore, we can write V0 by R. Once you get this equivalent circuit, now we will go to find out the parameters. Now, IF we have already seen this minus V0 upon R dash. Then beta factor is called as a feedback factor. Feedback factor means the output of the feedback is the feedback current IF and the input to the feedback circuit is the sampled output voltage V0. So IF by V0 is the feedback factor beta and this beta is equal to minus 1 by R dash. From this you can calculate IF upon V0 is minus 1 upon R dash. So this minus 1 upon R dash. Now the most important thing is the RMF. It is called as the trans resistance with feedback. In general, we can write the AF. Since it is a voltage shunt feedback, in voltage shunt feedback we have in place of the AF, we can write RMF. This is trans resistance. In all four topologies, this factor is different. In shunt feedback, we have RMF. In current feedback, we have current gain AIF. In voltage feedback, we have the AVF, and in series current series feedback, we can have here the GMF, transconductance. So this factor change depending upon the feedback. Here it is a voltage shunt feedback, we will use the term RMF. So RMF is equal to RM upon 1 plus beta times RM. In general, AVF is equal to AV upon 1 plus AV into beta. In place of AV, we will write RM. In place of AVF, here we will write RMF. So this factor is 1 by beta. And this 1 by beta is from this, it is R minus R dash. Then calculate AVF. RMF you got, this is trans resistance with feedback, and this is the voltage with feedback, V naught by Vs. And it is equal to V naught upon Is into Rs. In terms of this feedback factor, you can put here from above. So you will get minus R dash by Rs. So these two factor we have find, three factors here. Beta, RMF and AVF. Now, we will find the open circuit trans resistance, that is RM. This is the trans resistance with feedback, RMF. Now we find the RM. RM is V naught by Is, and V naught is equal to I naught upon R dash C upon Rs minus IC into I naught is equal to IC minus IC, and this is R dash C upon Is. What is this R dash C? Now you can look at the circuit. R dash C will be equal to RC parallel to R dash. In last circuit equivalent diagram, or in original diagram, you can see that this R dash C will be equal to RC parallel to R dash. So you can calculate the value of RC parallel to R dash. So you can calculate this value, put the values, and you will get here 2.1K. Now calculate this current gain minus IC by IB. So minus I here, once again we will go back here, AVF, RM, RC dash we have calculated here. Then calculate this minus IC by IS to calculate the current gain. This minus IC by IB into IB by IS. This is the output current and this is the input of the transistor current. And this is the input of the transistor current and this is the source current. So in two step this is calculated. So minus IC by IB is nothing but current gain AI, which is of transistor output current upon transistor input current. And this is given HFE. So this is minus 50. And now we have to calculate IB by IS. You can go through the equivalent diagram and see R is the parallel combination of R dash and this RS. So this R upon R plus HI. HI is the input resistance of the transistor. You can put these values. We have all these values. This R is given here. RS parallel to R dash. This value is calculated 8.33. Put this value and we will get this RM. Here these values are kept here. So we will get the output, open loop trans resistance is minus 92.715 kilo ohm. Now beta factor is minus 1 upon R dash. We have already initially calculated it. Put the value of R dash here, minus 1 by 50K. So here you will get the factor beta, minus 2 into 10 raised to minus 5. Now calculate the D. D factor means it is a return difference. That is 1 plus beta times R. In general, we can write this D means A upon 1 plus A beta. So 1 plus A beta is called as the D factor. Similarly here, D is equal to 1 plus beta into RM. You know all these values we have calculated. This D factor is 2.854. Then RMF, that is trans resistance with feedback, that is RM by D. Here one more thing you must remember. In two topologies, this gain, closed loop gain here, trans resistance particularly, will be open loop gain divided by D. And in two cases, it is D into this particular gain. In shunt, it is Rm by D, R open loop gain divided by D. And in shunt series, it is Rm into D. So depending upon the topology, you can use this formula. The table is there. You can see the table of general formulas of four topologies. And from this, you can write this one. In shunt topology, you have to write Rm by T. This value is minus 32.48 K, and later on AVF is equal to, we can calculate minus 3.248. So here, once you get, then calculate RI. RI is equal to R parallel to HIE. This value is 0.97 K, just you have to calculate. Then RIF, you calculate RI by D in same fashion. D factor is important. Calculate this value. It is an open loop, so output impedance, at the output it is open loop, so output impedance is infinite. ROF is also infinite. Then R dash O is the effective output impedance, which is RO parallel to RC dash. R dash C we have already seen, this is parallel combination, and this value is 2.1K. And lastly, you can calculate output impedance, effective output impedance or resistance with feedback. R dash O by D, you can calculate 735.8. So in this way, you can calculate the parameter of the voltage shunt feedback. Our dear students, kindly go through these numericals and see the problems from the book and the notes provided by me. If you have any difficulty, doubt, you can feel free to ask me at any time on any of the platform. There are number of platforms nowadays in this lockdown mode. So you can easily ask to me either on Google platform or on email or on WhatsApp, etc. Whatever may, or you can call me also. Thank you very much. Thank you.